Effie, Curtis was supposed to...
Love me. Curtis was supposed to love me.
There you are, Effie. I've been looking all over.
I turned my back and found myself out on the line. You could have warned me, but that would have been too kind.
I've been warning you for months to clean up your act. You've been late, you've been mean, giving all kinds of bullshit flack.
That's a lie, that's a lie. It's just I haven't been feeling that way.
Effie, please, stop excusing yourself. You've been late, you've been mean, and getting fatter all the time.
Now you lie, I never been so thin. You lie, cause you're knocking off that piece of thing. She's better than everybody.
She ain't better than anybody.
She ain't nothing but common.
Now who you call?
What is going on, y'all? I had to come in here and give y'all this Married to Medicine review. But I just wanted to give y'all that little piece of Curtis was supposed to love me, because that's how I feel about Jackie. That's how the girls felt about Curtis coming on this trip. At least that's how Toya felt anyway. She felt like Curtis was supposed to love Jackie. So let's get right on into this this episode 11, I believe it is. The episode start. I was in my phone during this episode. I believe either I was on my phone or I was doing something. So I did get bits and pieces of it. It didn't get interesting to the end of the episode. That's when I started paying attention. But Heavenly, that lady was right about you when she was like, you need to learn some self-control. And you do. She was absolutely right. You do need to learn some self-control. And, you know, figure out exactly who to respond back to, because you do have a problem with that, speaking out against on your mouth a lot. But I like you, girl, so I'm gonna let you stand. I like Mariah's husband. I like Mariah's husband more than I like her. I would rather see him more than I saw Mariah. Oh, my little bit of wine gone. But I would rather see him more than I saw Mariah. And I'm glad that Jackie and Curtis are working things out or whatever, but online counseling, I don't know how I feel about online counseling. I just think that, you know, I guess it works. If it works, you know, cool. But I just think if I'm paying my money to somebody and y'all live in a big city like Atlanta, I need you to see me and feel me and smell me, because I don't know. I just think that, like, as far as online counseling goes, I don't think that the counselor can actually see the exact body language as to the spouses, as to, okay, the wife says something, the husband, you know, he could put on for that little FaceTime, but, and I feel like actual body language in person, it'll be different. And that's just what I think about that. And it may work for some people. I'm not knocking online counseling, because we do live in a day and time. People are busy. They got kids. They need to bloop, bloop, bloop. Let's do this and move along. If that works for you, cool. But me personally, if I'm going to do counseling and pay you all my coins, I want to see you, and I want you to see me. Everybody seemed happy to be going on this trip. And then Curtis pulled up, and it was just like, whoa, what the fuck is Curtis doing here? Curtis was supposed to love me. I don't know. Everybody was really upset about Curtis, you know, coming on this trip. Let me slow down, because I feel like I'm talking fast. What really got me at the point was when Curtis, you know, you trying to get your wife back already, and you're going to pull Toya into your lap like that? That really wasn't a good look. I don't care. Dude, that really was not the move for you to pull. And I fucks with Jackie. Jackie has a personality that just, I feel like all of the girls can learn something from her, because she has so much self-control and stuff like that. Because I would have been like, motherfucker, I gave you a chance. Motherfucker, I didn't want you on this trip, but now you got to leave this motherfucker. Because you can pull her in your lap like that, motherfucker, you ugly as hell. You look like Shrek, too. Said I wouldn't cuss him out today. But You know, that's just what he looks like. He looks like straight to me, like an old, ugly-ass ogre, Dr. Jackie. I just think you can do so much better than that. But, you know, it's not all about looks. It's really not. It's not all about looks. Y'all, something just popped up on my computer and told me I need to check my security. Somebody was logging into my account. Shit, they ain't getting no motherfucking money anyway. Quad on his trip, and Dr. G, he was just kind of like, why would you air our business? I don't know if that was the time and the place for her to actually say that their marriage was going through something and it was such in a bad state, even though I get that she didn't want to be fake about it and be like, listen, I'm not about to be sitting here with y'all being fake, acting like everything is kumbaya, because it's not. I'm just letting y'all know what the tea is. We are not happy. Heavenly, I like that I like you on this trip, and I like that game that you played, because I'm gonna tell you what, you, that game you played, it actually brought some tea out in all the marriages or whatever, and I was here for it. It was messy, but it was factual and intrusive at the same time, because it really did show that, you know, Quad and Dr. G are going through something, and it was like, Toya and her fat ass husband, whatever they're going through, you know. I just was here for it. And what was going on at the table? Mariah. Toya and her husband, I feel like they're not really going through anything, but I'm gonna tell y'all something. Simone filed papers back on Cecil in October. I was so distraught about that shit yesterday. I don't know what. I don't even know. But I'm going to get to that at the end of this video. How many minutes I got? 7 minutes. Okay. Toya, I get what you're saying. I totally understand what you're saying. You didn't want Jackie to, you know, Curtis shouldn't be on this trip or whatever. And, you know, I totally understand what you're saying. You don't say nothing to me. Cool. But you were making that situation worse than what it had to be. You should have voiced your opinion and just moved on from it, because Jackie is the one that has to live in that household with her infidelity as husband. Curtis was supposed to love Jackie, not Curtis, not Toya, okay? Toya, I just felt like you just was taking it overboard as to the fact you were like, I don't want him to say nothing to me or whatever, and your husband be in the basement jacking off every day, so, I mean, I don't know. Because, you know, something, he could say the same thing about you. He might not be fucking those women, but is he really having an idea about those women or sleeping with them? I don't know. Some people do look at porn as cheating, so if you really want to take it there, I mean, we could. Moving right along. Curtis was supposed to love Jackie, but, what else was going on? I do like the fact, though, with that being said, how Toya was acting, I do like the fact that Toya is stupid as hell, but I like the fact that she's not ever with the shit. She's not with the fake shit, the dumb shit. She's like, okay, if we gonna be here, we gonna do this shit right. I do like that about Toya. But on to this Simone and Cecil thing, I wanna get serious for a minute, because they were the next best thing after Jackie and Curtis happened. Like, they were the epitome of the, okay, on Married to Medicine. And now they're getting a divorce. So I'm just like, and to me, maybe, I don't know. I feel like she was saying that, you know, after the show stopped taping, they stopped doing counseling, they started getting into it to me. And I think their argument wasn't really serious enough to split up. I think what happened with that was, it's like, who wants to be right or who wants to be wrong in that matter of, I think what was, it was a lot of, oh, you work a lot, you do this a lot, and it's back to that Jackie and Curtis thing again, as to where you're choosing your business over here. And to me, I think that if you are with somebody and a busy, it's just like dating a musician. a surgeon, like, she's an OBGYN, you know that they're going to be busy. It's just like, a lot of these girls out here, they're going out here and they're dating these rappers, and, you know, we hear about, oh, he slept with such and such, and it's kind of like, oh, well, some people be like, oh, yeah, she knew what she was signing up for, which, in all in actuality, which that could be true, because they do have a lot of pussy thrown at them, and, you know, like an OBGYN, she's going to be working all the time, she's going to be on call every weekend. They had the North and the South House in Atlanta. I feel like that was problem number one. I feel like he's IT. He's an IT guy, whatever. I feel like we don't need to have no two houses. I'm not staying in no other house because I feel like that was issue number one. I was like, oh, red flag. But I don't know. Here's the hope that maybe they'll work things out because they've been together for 21 years. That's 21 years gone down the drain. Hell, I know when I was in my two-year relationship, I was devastated because I was like, damn, that's 2 years of my life gone that I can't get back. I do not promote breakups. I do not. Whether it be, you know, whatever happened, I just think, hey, okay, nobody's perfect or whatever. I just think if y'all aren't compatible anymore, y'all can't move past some stuff anymore, let it go. But as far as little shit like arguments and stuff, but as I totally understand what Simone was saying, because as you get to the point where y'all start arguing, it's annoying to the point you walk in the house and you mad at what color that motherfucker got on that day, it's time to move on. But maybe their separating will make them miss each other, and maybe they'll get back together, because I feel like they do love each other in 21 years together. Who you trying to start over with after being with somebody for 21 years? You know their sex patterns. You know how to exercise your neck with them. You know what they like. You know, they know what you don't like. I mean, here's to hoping that they work shit out. I'm hoping that they work shit out. Because I actually like Simone and Caesar together. I really like Caesar. He's like one of my favorite husbands on this show. So, I don't know. I guess we'll find out what's going on at the reunion. Because I know that's how the tea came out. They taped the reunion. You know, somebody had to go back and tell it or whatever. So, here's to hoping. But, yeah, this was an okay, a decent episode. I'm about to get in here and, give y'all some review, because I've been missing all this week. I keep trying to watch Love & Hip Hop Miami, but it's just not happening for me. I don't know. I'm going to try to get in here and watch the episode Monday. We'll see what happens. But, you guys need to follow me on Instagram. I have a whole different thing that I do on Instagram from YouTube. I do a little bit of funny shit on Instagram. My Instagram is Keeping Up With Trizzy. Make sure you guys follow me. Subscribe to my channel on YouTube. If anybody watches this and wants to leave content, whether it is bad or good, I accept it. I accept it. But yeah, I'm getting out of here. I'm about to get back in here and make another video. Thank you guys for watching.